with me during this.
Okay, I got the elevator and rudder glued up and patched up real good and got it strengthened up a lot with a bunch of 30-minute epoxy. And this is, the more you look on a plane, the more you'll find. And this was a lead I found. I was looking them over. When we first started doing these ends, we weren't real good at them. And this little end that went into the receiver on channel 2, the rudder, actually it's aileron, not the aileron, but elevator. But anyway, the little lead didn't look very good, so I'm going to redo it real quick. It is a female end. So I'm going to redo it real quick. It really just shows exactly what I was saying earlier. When you go over a plane to fix it up after it's been in service for a year or so, which this one has, it's amazing how many things you find. And if you look very closely, you're going to find a lot of different things. And so expect it. When you find one, go ahead and fix it. If you can.
We're going to try to ask in the brain.
Things like this. I actually had one of these leads on a buddy of mine plane. It was at the receiver, and it's what it is. It's the blue wires are pulled out. I don't know if you can see that, but they're really close to the edge. And anyway, they pulled against each other and shorted out a control surface, and made it intermittent. And he was able to get the airplane down. And then we checked it out and found that was the case. And
that means we need to start protecting water pipes.
So something like this can crash your airplane very easily. So if you find anything like this, get it taken care of immediately.
Okay, and one of the things that we've heard a
lot
about
on it.
Are people getting a little bit.
Now, I also noticed I've got a few there on my,
obviously we want to keep them.
Well, they're all going to be my ailerons on my wing when I was checking it. They don't look that good either. So I'll probably redo them. Again, any potential problem that you can find, go ahead and take care of it. It doesn't take that long to work out the details. And then it'll give you peace of mind at the field that your model is bulletproof. Yeah, I wouldn't say bulletproof, but the bottom line is you're not going to have very many problems if you do everything you can do to fix the details, which is what I do.
Right, right. Very, very wise words.
I dropped my little pen down there in the plane is what I'm doing
now. And of course, you can stay tuned to the Ozark's Best Country, 102.9 The Z, and the entire Earls Family Broadcasting family of stations.
Really hard.
We'll keep you up to date. From the Ozark's Best Country, 102.9 The Z.
Good afternoon, I'm Dylan Davis with your closing cattle market numbers. April live cattle closed to 144.97, up 52.2.
Most planes, these are actually built real well, but most of them have stuff in the bottom there that is just covering. If you drop something in and you're trying to get it out, it's easy to puncture or damage that covering. This one is mostly sheeted, so it's not that big a deal. Anyway, I got it out. It's one of my pens.
It's important to feed your animals during cold, sleet, snow, and rain.
I'm just basically repairing an end. I'm putting a new end on one of my receiver leads. So I'm going to go ahead and get that done, and I'll be back.
National Healthcare Ratings Firm.
We are okay, I got my new lead that goes to my elevator. I got it made. I just had to put a new end on it. The end didn't look that good. I'm going to go ahead and put up my pens and stuff that I used to make when I say that. I need to do a few more here. Anyway, I'm going to go ahead and put my receiver back in its spot.
Resulting in physical injury, psychological trauma, or death. We are fortunate to have our local women's sanctuary offering women and their children a safe place to go.
Make sure it sits down nice.
On your donations and purchases to fund this worthy life-saving organization.
With
the
Velcro.
On the Harrison Square.
And I use a little bit of
big heart. The sanctuary shop invites
foam underneath them usually. For vibration.
then get CenturyLink high speed.
I tie it from pretty well every direction.
It's super fast.
Make sure it's very secure.
And it's just $19.
I secure my antenna end.
With unlimited nationwide
okay.
Plus, your
and I make sure that it stays away from any of the
that's
controls.
So call CenturyLink
as far as the wires, when I'm using my Velcro to tie everything down, I try to position my wires and everything with my Velcro at the same time.
Pay attention here.
To stay out of the way of my servos and everything. And I pretty well got that done on this. Got that tied back down. And I've got some weights in here that I rigged up. I had to rebalance it at the field because I put a different motor on it. And I got some weights that I rigged in here and did a fair job, but I'm going to probably redo them next. I'll be right back. Okay, I'm getting ready to start on the wing, the control rods and stuff now. And I am going to redo some of these ends here. But first of all, I'm going to go ahead and separate the wing. It's a two-piece wing, very hard to handle, it's huge, very hard to handle without damaging, it's got sloped ends, so it's very hard to handle. But anyway, so I'm going to go ahead and take it in half, that'll make it a little easier to handle, and then I'm going to clean it up, and like I said, everything I touch, I clean them up because really honestly you're just not going to get none of that clean at the field a lot of times. You're wanting to get out of there for the day and you're wanting to get loaded up and you're just not going to do as good a job. And I also got some places here where I've taped my edges. I'm going to go ahead and take that off. I'm going to show you how to take that off. You may not need a heat gun on this. Sometimes I do. I have this spot on the wing where I taped it in the past now. Actually taped this part on the wing because my muffler on my other engine, different engine than the one on it now, my muffler at the time was actually real close to that spot on the wing, and so I put a little tape there. Now here's how you take your tape off if it's been on a while. Very carefully heat it up. And I'm making my lights go on off because it pulls so much current. Now let me plug this into a different plug-in. I've got one right here handy. Okay, that one shouldn't be so bad. Anyway, you heat it up a little bit, doesn't take much, and that tape should just come right off. It is. It's much easier. You pull directly down, you don't pull out away, you pull down. A little bit of heat makes a huge difference in how well that tape goes up. But like I said, you still pull it from the side. You don't pull it straight up. You still will pull your covering off very easily.
The Ozarks Best Country 102.9, the Z, Hell of a Life, Frankie Ballard, Easton Corbin on the way with the new one.
Okay, I got that piece off. Rascal Flats, get more. Now, I'm going to go back to my straight denatured alcohol. 43 degrees, the Ozarks Best Country. Well, actually, I'm going to go ahead and get this other piece off. I've got another piece here. You see, it's been on there even longer. Okay, it's gonna come right off. Got another piece right here on this edge. I might have to iron that down. There's usually a reason why it's there. Yeah, I'm gonna have to iron that down a little bit. I'm gonna have to keep that. But back to what I was saying earlier. The more you look, the more you find. These planes don't have to be perfect to fly, but the better condition you keep them in, the longer they're gonna last, the better they're gonna fly. So a lot of the little details like this, and of course will help the looks tremendously. Now granted, tape is great in the field to repair your airplane. Well, you can just put some, I usually use cheap packing tape, which works great. The expensive stuff doesn't work as good, but it works great in the field to repair a spot or to hold an edge down where your covering's coming up. But, now try to come back and later on when you have the time, go ahead and try to repair that spot the way it should be repaired instead of just leaving tape on it and calling it good enough. Again, it's hard to do. If it's, you know, if it's flying good and everything, then boy, I've already got it. I don't need to worry about it. And all those little places that you have taped and everything, you just don't think about it. But if you pull these planes out every once in a while like I do, and try to go over them and try to repair them, you really, really can take care of a lot of problems. This plane, I'm really going to like it with the larger engine. I've got a video up of it flying the other day. And I'm going to start flying it quite a bit, so I really want to make sure that these details are taken care of. And this is the easiest stuff to overlook. The plane seems to be flying fine. You don't really seem to have any problems with it. Why look for problems with it? Because all your planes will have issues, and they have issues, and so why not go ahead and try to be working those issues out when you do have some extra time to work on it? Kind of fine-tune it. I have a lot of guys that I see, you know, they ask, boy, your airplanes are, they're ready to go, boy. Didn't have much problem with yours, and this is why. This is why I don't have that many problems, usually. I have some times that I do.
You guys played the best.
Most of the times I don't.
One great song after
and this is why. A little bit of extra attention when I get the time. I'm gonna go ahead and start heating up the iron. Iron down these edges. Now, what I'm doing now is I'm actually taking denatured alcohol and I'm wetting down the sticky from the tape. You can get the tape off, but it leaves that sticky film. Once you wet that down real good, it'll roll off. You can kind of give it a second to soak in it. You can come back and you'll just roll right off there. Now if you try to scratch that off with your thumbnail or something, you'll damage it to where you can see it. I even did it a little bit with trying to get the tape off. See, you can start seeing where my edges are peeled up and everything. Now again, get a little denature on it, on the sticky. Let it set for just a second. We'll go ahead and penetrate it instead of smear it. There we go. Starting to take it off real good. You gotta get that sticky off so you can go back with a iron and iron your covering down, which is usually the reason why the tape is there in the first place. So. My hands are getting all sticky from that sticky from the tape. And you gotta keep wetting it down. Now you see this little blue piece of tape? Now I leave those on my airplanes, and those are for my CG. And really, that little piece of tape doesn't get in the way of anything. And a lot of times I'll change a little something on a airplane, and I can immediately stick my fingers underneath it at the field and check my CG. Or even if something inside the airplane comes loose and you kind of have to reattach some things, you need to immediately recheck your CG. See, here's a spot where my little iron cross was coming up. See this or not? I got another piece of tape on it. You gotta be real careful not to damage anything. This is the different tape, and it's more expensive, and it's really nowhere near as good.
Giving Forsyth and the rest of the Ozarks the best country. 1029 the Z.
You can see it's much easier to get off. I say it's nowhere near as good. It's easier to get off, but that means it'll come off easier in flight. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and get the sticky off of that. Then I'm gonna clean this whole wing up. I'm gonna go ahead and do it with my Windex with a mix of denatured in it. I'm gonna go ahead and clean it up real nice. Then I'm gonna heat up my iron and go ahead and try to get it ironed down nice. All my edges and everything that were coming up. No matter how much you try, you'll never get your plane that clean at the field. I don't care how much of a perfectionist you are. Now, you can clean it really good, and you can come back and look at it again the next day, and you'll find that you can clean it again. So, every time I pick up a piece to work on it, I clean it. And if it doesn't need to be cleaned that much, it's real easy to clean because it didn't need that much. Makes it easier to work on, makes it look better. I have a friend of mine that helped me work on a plane lately, and he made a comment about another RC pilot that we know from another place, that the guy just didn't keep his planes clean. And he didn't. He just didn't take, the time. I'm just trying to get a little something stuffed into that from the paper towel. Anyway, he just most of the times didn't take the time to clean his planes up very good, and he probably did try to get them fairly clean, and thought he had got them fairly clean, but other pilots and other people will notice real quick if your plane is really dirty and it just looks bad. And no more time than it takes to clean them up, why have them look bad? But anyway, I got it all cleaned up pretty decently. I could probably clean it even better, but it's not bad. I miss maybe sitting on the porch drinking ice cold cherry coke. Now I'm going to go ahead and heat my iron up, and I'm going to start cleaning on the other wing. I'm going to set this one over here to the side. Okay, I'm gonna set it right here and I'm gonna start. I'm gonna plug my iron up so it can be heating up. Okay. And I'm gonna start cleaning on this one and looking for tape and stuff. This one looks really dirty. Sometimes it takes a little bit of denatured alcohol in your Windex to cut. Now, this has got a lot of little specks from running a gas engine. The gas engine I had on it before was a Evolution 26cc, which is a very good engine. Just wasn't quite enough power for this large of an airplane. But anyway, you get these little black specks from the exhaust. And these little black specks are kind of hard to get off of your wing or your fuselage or wherever you get it off your covering. And that's where a little bit of denatured alcohol, and actually I put quite a bit of denatured alcohol in my Windex, and it really helps cut that. Clean it up pretty good. Really try to take some time to get it nice and clean. Don't just wipe it over and look at it. Look at it closely and see that you actually got the stuff that's on it. Sometimes you gotta scrub. It's real easy to tell at the field the guys that care about their airplanes looking nice and flying nice, and their airplanes do fly nice. And then you get the guys that don't take care of their stuff, and their stuff doesn't work very well. And it's funny because they wonder why their stuff doesn't work good and yours does. You know, everybody just shrugs their shoulders. I don't know. But everybody knows. It's because you don't take the time to take care of your stuff. And that's a big part of it, cleaning. Looking for defects, going back over your airplanes, trying to fix them up. I got a 60 size big stick over there that I don't know, I would say it's flown a couple hundred flights at least. It's one of my favorite airplanes. Hardly ever had any problem at all with it. I mean, it's just incredible. Have almost no problems with it at all, but I do go over it quite often like this, and try to work out the details on it. That's probably why I don't have any problems. Which that particular plane that I'm talking about actually is due to be gone over. It's needs a little bit of attention. This one does, and it's getting it. Alright, there we go, cleaned up, ready to work on. I've got my iron heated up. I'm looking for any places this one might need. This looks like a few edges, maybe. I'm gonna go ahead and hit them. Your edges will almost always try to peel up over time. Oh, I found a piece of tape on this one. And go ahead and get that off. I didn't see that a minute ago. Got a little piece of tape right here. Again, I heat my tape up a little before I try to pull it off. really makes a difference. How easy it pulls off. Doesn't take much heat. Again, there's a reason why this piece of tape's here. That edge was peeling up. That piece of tape didn't even leave any of the sticky behind. That is great. So that's what I'm going to do. Is I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to iron that little spot down. That's why that tape was there. Iron it down real good. And these edges just peel up after a while. I'm handling it, put it in and out of the truck or whatever. They just peel up. So go ahead and heat them back down. And take your time to go ahead and do a good job and get them actually glued down. Sometimes it takes quite a bit of heat. Sometimes the heat gun won't put them down. Sometimes you have to go back with a little bit of CA to get these down. Most times an iron will do it. Of course I use these socks. Otherwise it kind of smears your color. Okay. Got that pretty good. Now I'm going to go to the other one. I've got several places on the other one. Now, first of all, one of my main places is right on the corner of my iron cross here. Right there on that corner. Taped. Yeah, I can see why it was trying to come loose. I don't know if you can see it, but that's what happens when you use too much CA in a spot. It goes through and it looks bad. But anyway, let me go here. Okay, there's an edge that needs to be put down.
The Ozarks Best Country 1029, the Z. Why God?
Okay, I'm going to go ahead and iron these down and
my name is Matt Duncan.
Get ready to work on the control linkages and I'll be back. Situation. Okay, I got all my covering iron down real nice where I pulled all my tape off. Now, is what I'm doing today, and of course, I'm probably going to redo these ends. Yeah, that one needs to be redone. That one needs to be redone also. They're starting to pull out of the end. When we first started doing our own ends, it's kind of a learning process, and we weren't as good at it as we are now, so I need to redo those ends. Okay, and then this right here, this control linkage is my flaps. And I'm not going to have flaps anymore. I'm going to go ahead and convert them over to ailerons. So let me see here. I believe I got the right. I got a couple control rods here. And what I will do,
psychological trauma or death, we are fortunate to have our local women's sanctuary offering women and their children a safe place to go.
Those are set up on the center.
Donations and purchases to fund this worthy life-saving organization. The sanctuary
really
shop
odd.
In Harrison Square, a little thrift store with a big heart. The sanctuary shop invites you to shop because it matters.
At Dentures and Dental Services,
they should be able to get by with it.
A great smile. For over 14 years, they've been providing affordable general dentistry for the people of the Ozarks, and their fees are still among the lowest you'll find anywhere. Routine extractions are still only $39 each with immediate dentures, and you can get a complete set of replacement dentures for as low as $3.95. Give them a call today at 870-741-1577.
Yeah, I should be able to get by with it.
Services of Harrison, where you can't afford a great smile. Thomas John Kennedy of Arkansas, DDS, PLLC and Associates.
Come with me.
Go ahead and pull my...
Change the world.
So, the young porn off here.
Son of God, now showing on the giant screen at the IMAX Entertainment Complex.
I am.
Son of God spans the life of Jesus from his humble birth through his teachings, crucifixion, and ultimate resurrection. Son of God,
really
from
the giant screen
at the IMAX Entertainment Complex, shows nightly at 5 and 8.
You know, okay.
Going green.
Well, basically, right here, I'm going to take this end off.
Going green for quite a while. As a matter of fact, one of the first in the area to use paint that's safe for the environment and looks the best on your car.
Using I had Loctited it. So PPG gives
the best match of color ever. And don't forget, if you have problems, they have 24-hour towing available. When you need body work done, call Ozark Auto Body on Main Street in Harrison, 741-4722. 1029 The Z. Weather brought to you by Got Heat and Cooling. An investment in solar energy system could increase your energy self-reliance and even increase the value of your home. Goff Heat and Cooling now offers SunSource solar energy systems. Call Goff Heat and Cooling today to see how you could get free energy. 1-800-417-GOFF or
goff.com.
You're better off with Goff.
Loctite on them. That way they won't come loose. Okay, there's that end. There's my backup nut. Okay, and then I'm going to go ahead and take my screw lock, which is what that is.
129 the Z radar shows some scattered rain across the region, nothing major. 43 degrees at the Z.
Radar presented by New Beginnings Cosmetology in Harrison.
Hi, this is Jeree from New Beginnings School of Cosmetology. Our $2,500...
Figure out what size it is, whether it's metric or standard. Like I said, everything goes back and forth.
So call 743-1114 to claim one of our few spots.
I just do it per item. And try to remember which ones are which.
Best choice for severe weather coverage. 1029, okay. The Z.
Loosen that up, and that won't come out. All right. Now I'm going to take one of my new ones. I've got a full length of IM packages of six or whatever, and they're 12 inches long, I believe. Okay, I'm going to run my little backup nut on there. And then I'm going to put my control clevis up on there, and I'm going to run it up to about... these little ears there. Run it up to about there. And when I get completely done with this, I will Loctite these again. Actually, you can actually hold these because it scars it up a little bit. Way down here where you know you're going to cut off. Because it does scar it up a little bit. No reason to scar it off. Scar it up where you're going to see it. Anyway, I go ahead and I run that up till it's right there at the little ears that they give you to put your fuel tubing for safety in your clevises. And I do that so I've got adjustment both ways. To adjust it out, I've got plenty of adjustment both ways that way. Okay, right up to there. Now technically I would take when I'm done and I'll run my lock nut right up to it with a little bit of Loctite on it. I'm not going to worry about that right now. Now is what I'm going to do is I'm just going to set this. I'm just going to turn my servo to where it's 90 degrees, and I'm going to go ahead and hook my levers back up to my control arm, and I'm going to slide it to my screw lock. Okay. And I'm going to set that right there on my servo. And I'm going to put my screw back. And that'll give me a real good idea of what I need to do for length. And it'll also let me see if these will work from this angle. Should. Which they look like they're going to. What I did, and it was a mistake, but I set it up with flaps. I just wasn't thinking. I thought, you know, I have flaps on an airplane, great, might as well use them. So what I did is I mounted my control horns on my control surface, which is right here, and I mounted them just about even with the servo, which I normally do it offset. And is what that did is it made it this horn should be set over a little bit. So it's a little angled, it won't hurt anything. It looks like it's gonna work just fine. Let's see here. Now it actually looks like it's set up to go this way. Probably set up and go this way. Like I said, I'll hook my receiver up later and check this out and see if it works. I know it'll work. I'll fine tune it. Okay, there it is. I take my control surface, I put it about level. Okay, then I can just come over here with a pair of snippers. I must have put them up. Okay. And I go ahead and snip this off. Now I'm going to leave a fair amount on that. I can snip it off again later. I'm going to leave a fair amount on it just in case I need to do some adjustments. Those are pretty hard to cut. You definitely want to hold on to this other end because that will go flying across the other end, or across the rim and hit something. There we go. Now. Looks pretty good. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to sand off a little sharp spot on it. Every time you cut one of these off with a pair of snippers, you're going to leave a real sharp spot on it. Always sand it off so you don't have that. It's like you have a little razor blade knife on your plane.
Is Big Wayne Murphy, black shitting on the way, and what she likes. If you're in a good girl, on the station getting next time, we're still our speed best country. 1029 the Z. Hey, kind
girl. When you're doing that, go ahead and feel of it and see if you've got the sharp point off, because you can stand on it for quite a while and not get it. Now, I've got that. I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to set my, which should be my secondary aileron now. I'm going to go ahead and set it level. I'm going to go ahead and put a little Loctite on this end. Run my backer nut up. Now, I let it wick into my clevis a little bit. I don't put it into my clevis and then run my thread up, which is what I did before. That's why it was so hard to get off there. I just run it up a little bit. I let it wick in. I put it on the back side, and then I run the little back nut up, okay? And then I go ahead and I pop my clevis in together. Most of them snap. Okay? And I go ahead and I push up my safety piece of fill line. Make sure my control surface is still centered. Now I'm going to go ahead and pull my screw lock bolt out. Put a little bit of fresh Loctite on it. And normally I wouldn't do this without having the receiver hooked up, and I will go back and fine tuning later, but is what I do here is I go back later, hook it up to the receiver, and I pull my servo horn off of it. Turn the receiver on, and then I set it up, and I really have pretty good luck doing it this way. It's probably a little better to go ahead and do it with your receiver hooked up and on. See, that one started to push back on me a little. I just get my control surface level. I get my servo right at 90 degrees, which, like I said, when I turn on my receiver, that's not going to be at 90 degrees. So you got to make sure and take your servo horn back off before you plug it into your receiver and turn everything on. Okay? Go ahead and tighten up my screw lock. I really like these. Other guys don't. I don't know why. Okay, now that one's done. I do have to come back and redo my ends later. I'm going to go ahead and do my control rod, see how that ended up there. That'll be my other aileron. So I have two ailerons on this wing, which should really, really improve this plane. Of course, this plane flies incredible anyway, so you don't really have to have another aileron. But you don't need flaps. It's just a complete waste on this airplane to have flaps. So, if you've got the control surface there, you might as well make it into something you can use, and it will make the plane more controllable, for sure. So, even though you don't really need two ailerons on this airplane, it doesn't matter. Okay, we go to the same process here. Take that one off. It's my screw lock in. Okay, go ahead and take my clevis off. She likes it when I get past second gear. Sees gravel flying in the rear view. This one's on there pretty good. It's going to be kind of hard to do. Let me hold up with a pair of pliers and something here. There we go. This kind of stuff's pretty easy to damage, so you got to be pretty gentle with it. And see, my other end is the one that's threading, so I'm going to have to get my clevis started. I probably put a little too much Loctite on it last time, because my clevises are really froze up on there because of the Loctite, which is good and bad. Here I'm needing to take them off to reuse them. It's going to be awful hard to do because I've got so much Loctite on it. But I wouldn't have to worry about them coming loose and bite, because they won't come loose even with a wrench. So, there's got to be a way to get that one. Get a better pair of pliers here where I can hold it.